What up, fam? This is Vic from Quick Cuts Premium Lawn Care here in Conyers, Georgia. As always, hope you guys are cutting on. So today, fam, I'm going to talk to you about the John Deere. This one right here, we have over 1,000 hours on this bad boy. So we're going to give you what we really think about this piece of equipment. Yes, we're going to give you the truth and nothing but the truth. We ask you to please like and subscribe to the channel, because we're trying to get our subs up to 5,000 subs this year. And if you're coming on the channel, we ask that you please support us by hitting on that sub button, and also go ahead and hit the bell, and we'll greatly appreciate your support in growing our channel. All right, let's get to the business of this mower right here.
Tell you the pros and cons of this zero turn 54 inch John Deere. We have one of these, and then we have the rest are 60 inch, so they are pretty much the same other than just the deck size. But as far as being durable, this thing will take on anything. It takes hills, it takes small tree stumps. You know, of course, you don't want to, you know, push it, put your mower through that type of thing. But sometimes there's unexpected things that you might find in the yard that you just overlook. It endures it. The deck is really, really durable. We have on this side over here, we have what is called a mulch kit. This mulch kit saves hours of time in regards towards working on clients' home, because you can keep mulch from going into flower beds, garage doors, the streets, so you ain't got to come back and blow it up. This mulch kit will mulch the leaves up in the yards, or if you cut the hedges and you got to get some in the yard, it'll mulch it up to where you won't even tell that they're there. So this saves hours of time. But we have one that we just got that does not have the mulch kit, and it literally takes me probably an additional 30 minutes in time on larger yards in order to make sure that I can conceal everything, because I don't have the mulch. Now, I want to make sure that you understand that when I say mulch kit, this is not a grass flap. This is a mulch kit that's in there. Up under there, when you close this flap right here, there are three sections in there that closes as well, and it starts a spending going on inside, kind of like a washing machine, where it holds what is inside, grass, leaves, hedges, whatever, and it mulches into five pieces. A grass flap does not have sections. All it does is keep a lot of the debris from shooting out forwardly with force. But as this is mulching, remember, the grass flap, that debris is trying to get out. So it still can sneak up out of there and get into your flower beds, and you'll see unmulched leaves and things of that sort still there. Unlike with the mulch kit, it'll really grind it up really fine for you. As long as you want to keep running over it, it'll keep grinding it up for you. Now, some of you might ask, would I go with, you know, purchase a zero turn without a mulch kit? Well, like I said, we do have one, and we're gonna put a flap on it. But I would always suggest, if you have the money, to get the mulch kit, because it's gonna do a lot more as far as a cleaner look compared to the flap. So I would definitely, if the funds are there, invest in the mulch kit. So you might ask, well, why do we go and invest in one without the mulch kit? Well, there was one reason. It was a great deal, and we're gonna use that in order to be our backup mower whenever one of our mowers with the mulch kits goes down, so we can keep on cutting on. Now, we are gonna put a grass flap on there, but like I told you, in regards towards the difference between the two, it's for us, it's for a short term period, just until we can get our mower out of the shop if we can't get a fast return fix on it. All right, now some of the mowers come like a seat, like right here. You have the seat that can adjust the dial right here, so you can adjust your weight. We have one that you can't adjust your weight, so you got to be the right size to sit on that, or it's going to cut off on you. For me, I'm not the right size, so I had to put a weight on there with a cushion. So this one right here has the adjustable weight. Also, you have the seats that come spring-loaded to where it adjusts and balances your body weight, and you have some that's just a seat. So when you hit a bump, you feel that bump. This one right here is going to feel like sitting on clouds. So you have, of course, you have your armrest right there. For those that want to kind of rest the elbow so they're just not kind of dangling. Would you say, would we invest in one if it didn't come with the seat? The seat, you know, like I told you, there was one that we have that doesn't have the weight dial. So I have to put a weight on there, and I put a cushion on top of it. Hey, it's better to still get this right here. As long as it has this mulch kit, it doesn't care. It doesn't matter what seat. You can even, if you want to, if you have it long enough, you can change the seat out later down the line. But this mulch kit, I would say, is the most important part of this piece of equipment right here when it comes to being able to give a very beautifying type of line service cut. You see, we have the no flats on the front, a must. And I believe they come with the no flats because they know the lawn care business. But right here, these are options, the twills. Would we use them more without the twills, or do we suggest twills? And the answer is yes, that we would suggest, and no, we would prefer not to get them more without the twills. If it's a great deal, of course we'll get it and then get the twills along the way. But the back tires going in the yards, the weight of this mower, you have people who get their roof work done and there's nails and all kind of things that are just, you just cannot foresee. So therefore, we'll come back, get ready to start your day off. You do your morning check, everything looks good, get to the property, and then your tire is flat because somewhere it adjusted along the way. It was holding the pressure while you did your check, but then when you got to your property, you find yourself on a flat, and therefore it shuts your whole day down, or at least takes half of your day. So the twills are definitely, I would suggest, with this size, with this type, with this mower and the weight of this mower, to get twills. We have 1,050 hours on this mower. The warranty runs out at 1,300 hours. So the equipment has been in the shop just a few times. We had a couple of issues dealing with the foot pedal, the deck lift, and we had to replace that. There were some other issues that we had, but because of the warranty, we get it in and get it taken care of. That takes the stress off to where it's not as memorable. Now, we had a couple of mowers that went down due to the deck issues. We were doing a cleanup, and two of the guys ran over something, and it damaged the inside of the mulch kit deck. Now, that's one of the dilemmas that comes with the mulch kit, because if you damage that, your mower will not operate if the blades are not going to spin, and it has to be repaired. The repair for that was $800. Because they had to do welding in order to properly make sure that all three of the blades were spinning simultaneously without any rubbing or anything like that. And so therefore, that is one of the negatives, if I could say, regarding a mulch kit, but it's not under warranty when that gets damaged in that way. It's basically mechanical issues or things like that, that they say it breaks down outside of it being damaged by the operator. The battery life, the battery on these mowers, when we put the battery in, regardless if it's a battery that comes from the John Deere battery or AgPro battery, or a battery I get from AutoZone, for some reason the battery maintains it's life on these mowers. It's not any drainage compared to the other mowers that we have, the off-brand mowers. But these right here keep the batteries charged pretty well so that they operate throughout the year for us. All right, it does really good on gas. It takes 10 gallons. So, you know, unless you're just not really paying attention to your gas gauge, you know, you're not gonna run out of gas during a day's worth of work. During a day's worth of work, you're not gonna run out of gas. You can operate this thing starting at 6 in the morning to cooks at night, and it'll pretty much go all the way through. Now, regarding changing the blades, it's very simple. We have what is a heist, and we just kind of, you pull it back and pop it up. You get up under there real easily, and you can get those blades off. Normally, on some of them, when we first get them, it requires a lot more torque. So you got to make sure you have a really strong torque gun in order to make sure you loosen it. Because before we got the higher torque gun, we had to take it into the shop. And we end up getting the torque gun that we got to, you know, you plug it in so that way we can have more of that electrical power to be able to, rather than the battery, lithium batteries. You know, these right here, you still want to make sure you screw it all the way in. Make sure that you get your screw tight before you start doing any type of tightening. On here you have, there's 5 grease gun nipples, so that's really good. You'll have to be trying to look all over to find out how to make sure that your spindles or your wheels are right there are properly lubed. So it's 5 of them, 3 nipples inside each one of the blade areas, where the spindles are, and then the other 2 are on the side where the wheels are. We have to change the blade. It's very, very easy to change the belt. Change the belt. Very easy to change the belt. You know, you just drop the deck all the way down, and it's just pretty much, they have a guide on there. You follow that guide, and you can have that belt on within 15, 20 minutes. Now, as far as someone coming in, unless you can find a really good deal, they can be pretty pricey. But if you can afford it, I definitely would suggest it, because you're gonna get the durability out of it. It's gonna last. And John Deere is gonna back their product within the warranty. And you can make sure that you have some equipment that can be able to go out there and take on any line that you come up against. So if you have the funds to be able to purchase one of these, I definitely would suggest that you do, if you're starting out. If not, then, you know, look at our video regarding the Bradley mowers.
All right, fam, that's our review on the John Deere. We stand by it, and we're gonna run these green machines until someone, I guess, come in this area with something better and something that I would say more affordable. But other than that, we like the piece of equipment. You heard my brother D. So as always, fam, hope this helped you out. So Cut On Lawn Care family, cut on. We're cutting out. Peace.